Hi, my name is Kelly O. Schlegel. I'm the founder of Kelly O. Fitness. I'm a vegan athlete. I've been a coach and trainer for about 5 years now, vegan for 7 years, and I'm just getting started. A lot of the common misconceptions that I get as a vegan athlete is, I think everyone's heard it, where do you get your protein? It's silly, you know, that I hear it so often, but I can understand the question. A lot of people are just misinformed or misguided. Growing up, we think we have to eat the turkey, the ham, you know, the chicken, the beef, just to get our protein, not realizing that these animals get their protein from plant-based sources. So why don't we just dive in and go right to those sources as well and get it from the beans, the leafy, dark leafy green vegetables, the fruits, the nuts, the seeds, the grains. The greatest challenges that I come into play with as a vegan athlete is really just the morals and ethics and my values always on the line. In a health and fitness industry, you're constantly seeing supplements that are being pushed to vegan athletes or athletes in general that contain whey, which is a form of dairy. You're seeing these meal companies that are trying to prepackage your meals that are high in protein, that have chicken and beef. And it's not ideal for a vegan athlete to be navigating those things. I wouldn't say it's a bad challenge. I never find the word challenge in a negative connotation. I think it's always exciting to go headstrong and head front with a company that is trying to push anything animal-based and rather show them that the plant-based option is the way to go instead. My daily diet consists of just all plant-based meals. So I'll start my morning either with some oatmeal or some coconut yogurt with almonds, walnuts, chia seeds. Then I'll have some Clean Machine vegan protein powder, usually mixed with some soy milk. Later throughout the day, I'll have my homemade seitan that I usually bulk prep and meal prep on the weekends. Lots of black beans, chickpeas, dark leafy greens. And I love my berries, so strawberries and blueberries and things like that as well. When it comes down to training, I focus on a lot of hypertrophy styles of training. So a lot of heavy lifts, and the rep ranges or repetition ranges, anywhere between 8 to 12 repetitions, 3 to 4 sets. I really don't do a lot of steady state cardio. I prefer my high intensity interval training. So a lot of sprints on the treadmill or down the street, a lot of burpees and a lot of ab work. My best advice to anyone who is trying to build lean muscle mass or become a vegan athlete is to eat, just simply eat. Another common misconception with athletes in general is that you need to be in a caloric deficit to obtain the body you desire, when in actuality, your metabolism is craving more and more food. The more that you eat, the more energy you have, and the more easily you'll be able to build that lean muscle mass upon your body, curving your body into the way that you want and molding it into the way that you want. So my biggest advice is to eat, lift heavy, and stop doing cardio. limit the cardio.
Wow, really?
Yeah, limit the cardio and just really focus on lifting heavy. What? I say cardio is great. Cardio has the best benefit of being therapeutic for the mind and soul, you know, if you want. It kind of just helps you relax, but for transforming your body composition, not so much. When I was thinking about my clients' best success stories, it's really difficult to pinpoint because it sounds cliche, but they're like my children. You know, every one is so different, and I love each success story for all the different reasons. I will touch upon some of them that are very memorable to myself and also to the other Kelly O Fitness client athletes of mine who have formed this community around these people and seen their success. There was this one woman, she was actually my first client athlete I ever had. I trained her in studio, and she was legally defined as disabled. She got into a terrible vehicle accident, left her disabled, and she was on disability, couldn't work. She has four children, many of them were young. She came into my studio, and she had a good amount of body fat that she wanted to get rid of, but more importantly, she wanted to be able to walk again and just feel strong. So we started doing unilateral work, meaning doing a lot of lunges, just one side of the body at a time, whether it's, you know, pressing with just one side or stepping forward with one side. And one of my favorite moments to this day is doing a Bulgarian split squat with her. And I was helping her, and as she is descending to the ground and pushing herself back up, she starts crying, and then I start crying. It was just a beautiful moment of her realizing that everything that was holding her back was in her mind, and she was able to break through that. And ever since then, now she's down 70 pounds. She's down 70 pounds, she's an entrepreneur, like she's just amazing. Some of my other great success stories, doesn't always have to do with body composition, but more just pushing past those hurdles, those mental hurdles, and gaining that confidence. I have client athletes that never thought in, you know, ever in their life that they would be able to run a marathon. And now they've run multiple marathons, or done Spartan races and obstacle courses, and it's so beautiful to me. We're seeing a trend nowadays. The health and fitness industry is booming, and it's not going anywhere. People constantly want to be the best version of themselves, lose the body fat, gain lean muscle mass. But the one thing that can set you apart, you know, with your morals, ethics, and values, is also by positioning yourself as that vegan athlete, because right now it still is such a small segment of the health and fitness industry. And by positioning yourself in that light, as it's true to yourself, there's nowhere to go but go up from there, because people are interested in it. And people are constantly asking questions of, how can you get to the level that you're at by being a vegan athlete, a plant-based athlete? How do you make it work? People are interested in that, so there's constantly going to be press about it, social media about it, and we really do have the ability to make a difference with this platform, and that's what I love about what I do. I remember kids I went to school with are saying, like, you know, LOL, like, this isn't gonna last, or things like that, and it can be disheartening to some people, but for me, it was more fuel to that fire, and a couple of years later, now they're all reaching out to me saying, how can I become a client athlete? How can I substitute, you know, all the meat and dairy that I was eating and now bring in plant-based options? And so it's comical in that sense of, you know, people who first were making fun of it and not really understanding the positioning that we were doing is now saying, how do I get on board? So I think that's a beautiful aspect of it.